Apocalypse movement trays are an excellent resource for moving vast amounts of models across the battlefield. The great thing about these movement trays as well is you can use them for any gaming system. Now in this video, I'm going to be painting and adding textures to these movement trays to match my Freegold army, the Mighty Warriors of Haligild. Now the first thing we'll need to do is undercoat those trays. As you can see here, I've used Zandri Dust, which is perfect because it also means all those edges I don't need to paint. I can just leave them as they are. So we're going to add texture now, and we're going to start with Aglan Badlands. We're then going to shade it using Reichland Flesh Shade. We'll finish off with a dry brush of Screaming Skull, then we'll add some grass tufts, which are Midland tufts. So first of all, let's start adding that texture. So I'm going to use the texture tool, we'll use the large size first. So I'm just going to start splodging some of that on, like so. And all we need to do is then on the flat areas, on the actual movement tray, is then just start spreading that around like so. When you get to the edges, just use the small side. There we are, with the texture now dry, all I'm going to do now is start applying Reichland Flesh Shade. And I'm only going to be applying onto the top where the texture is. I don't actually want it to go into the areas where the bases will sit. With the shade now applied and dry, what I'm going to do now is dry brush Screaming Skull just on the raised edges. That's only on the areas that have texture. With the texture now dry brush, what we're going to do now is add some Midland tuff. So all I'm going to do is just sporadically place these across the movement tray. I'm going to be using different sizes as well, just to stop it looking too uniformed. So just take your time to keep adding new ones on. And there we are, the movement tray is done and it looks great. Now remember in this video I painted mine to match my army, but you can paint yours in whatever colours you want to. You can even just start by undercoating them and leave them like that and then add some texture at a later time. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoy making your own movement trays. I'm now off to add movement trays to the rest of my armies, so I'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.